everyone, and welcome to Bobcats Weekly. I'm your host, Hannah Cotter.
And I'm Justin Cloutier.
Baker Dunleavy has been hired as the new head coach for the men's basketball team. Dunleavy leaves behind his associate head coaching position at Villanova to replace Tom Moore here in Hamden. Dunleavy joins the Bobcats after 7 years at Villanova, where he helped the Wildcats win the 2016 National Championship. The formal announcement came at a press conference on Tuesday, where Director of Athletics and Recreation Greg Amodio was, quote, thrilled to welcome Dunleavy to the Bobcat community. When asked about his vision of the team, here's what he had to say.
Our assistant coaches will be Tom Pecora, who was previously the head coach at Fordham University and helped my mentor Jay Wright get it started from the ground at Hofstra. Sean Morris, who's been a vital piece of building the program at Boston University, a tireless recruiter, a big-time worker, player development, every piece. And then finally, Anthony Goins, who has been working at Yale and helped Coach Jones get it going there. Obviously, they beat Baylor in the NCAA Tournament last year. I just respect where all three of these guys have been. I respect their character, their work ethic, and above all, their ability as basketball coaches and developing young men.
In other news, the women's basketball team's Cinderella story came to an end this past weekend after losing 100-58 to number one South Carolina in the Sweet 16. Jen Fay and Adelie Martucci led the Bobcats with 12 points apiece. The Bobcats end their season with a 29-7 record, as well as making program history. Congratulations to Tricia Fabbri and her squad.
We head to New Haven for a men's lacrosse matchup between Quinnipiac and Detroit Mercy. First highlight here, Kevin Deal spin moves a defender and rips a shot, but it's saved, and Ryan Corcoran will put home the rebound for the goal. Ryan Lawson is going to take this out of the corner, and he will score. Frost will pass to Carchietta, and he will find the back of the net. Lawson here will hold this until he finds Brian Feldman coming from behind the net, and he will bury on this jumping shot. Bobcats will go on to lose 8-6. You saw the highlights, now let's check out some other Bobcat scores. Women's lacrosse lost to Monmouth 12-8, while baseball also lost to Monmouth, but in a three-game series. And softball defeated Wagner College in both games of their doubleheader, but lost to LIU Brooklyn over the weekend.
Men's and women's tennis lost to Wesleyan, but the women will play again on Sunday to defeat the University of Rhode Island.
Quinnipiac rugby won the third annual Crimson Sevens tournament. It was an offense kind of day for the Bobcats as they scored 215 points while only giving up 10.
Acrobatics and tumbling defeated Glensville State College in a landslide. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with more Bobcats Weekly.
Welcome back to Bobcats Weekly. Our own Tyler Brosious sat down with women's basketball head coach Tricia Fabbri. Let's check it out.
So has it all set in yet?
Not at all. Not at all. It's been going and rolling one day into the next, but enjoying every minute of it. Enjoying every second of talking about this team and what we were able to do.
And, you know, let's kind of get into it, because it seems like everyone on that team has their own special quirk, special thing that they bring to the team. We'll start with the seniors. What do you think their legacy will be?
Oh, my goodness. Honestly, for the three of them, can you think of a better ending? Can you think of a better way to, this is what we did before we left the program. We went to a Sweet 16, really, for Morgan, for Adelie in particular. I blocked Heidemann's shot, and then we went into the next round, the second round of the NCAA tournament, and Adelie, yeah, I hit the three-pointer with a minute left to put us back up fourth, and by the way, Morgan Manns, yeah, I hit six threes. I decided to, you know, to have a career high 22 that day to propel us into the Sweet 16. And that's all we did. And now we're going to the Sweet 16. Like, insane. Like, I just, can you imagine that's your legacy here from a program that's used to winning at high levels, winning championships, cutting down nets, going to the NCAA tournament, and saying that you want to win games in the NCAA tournament, but now you actually are in the second weekend of the NCAA tournament playing against the one seed South Carolina, and you have everything to do with helping your team get there. That's a pretty good way to say, yeah, that's a great career. Thank you, Quinnipiac.
What a truly historic run for the Bobcats.
You know, Hannah, history is the exact word I would use.
Now let's check out some upcoming games for the other Bobcats. Softball will be playing doubleheaders all weekend against Hartford, Rider, and St. Peter's University.
Baseball has a game against the University of Rhode Island and a three-game home series against Marist.
Both lacrosse teams will travel to Manhattan on Saturday, and acrobatics and tumbling will welcome Fairmont State University to the TD Bank Sports Center.
Men's tennis will have matches against Sacred Heart, Binghamton University, and Army, and women's tennis will be at Fordham University.
Women's outdoor track and fields will be at the Colonial Relays for the weekend, and rugby will be taking on AIC Harvard and Army in Springfield, Massachusetts on Sunday.
And that will do it for the upcoming games for the Bobcats. So we're nearing the end of our show, so it's time to check out our top play of the week. Our top play of the week comes from men's lacrosse. Kevin Deal spin moves a defender and rips a shot on goal, but it's saved, and Ryan Corcoran will put home the rebound. See that in slow motion. Picks up the ground ball and puts it upstairs. And that will do it for our show. I'm Justin Cloutier. Thanks for tuning in, Bobcat fans.
And I'm Hannah Cotter. Have a great night.